Top of the morning to you, or whatever time of day you happen to be watching this. Ireland, or Ireland as they call it, is rich with history, legends, and of course, their own style of music. Irish music is so popular that even video games have used it for action, adventure, fantasy, and RPGs. That's role-playing games, just in case your teachers didn't know that. We have to educate them.
Music that is associated with any country, people, or region is known as folk music. Every country has folk music. It's the music that comes from and is identified with that particular area. Even though Ireland is part of a larger country called the United Kingdom, its music is unique and has been around for hundreds of years. Irish folk music is commonly known as Celtic, which also includes other areas like the country of Scotland. Many of these songs are made for singing and dancing and range from upbeat, energetic tunes called reels and jigs to slower and more sentimental songs like ballads and laments. Many video games that use traditional Irish music are fantasy games that invent exciting new worlds for the player to explore. One of the longest-running fantasy adventure series in gaming is the Final Fantasy series. Longtime Final Fantasy composer Nobuo Uematsu was heavily inspired by the Irish band Alton and uses examples of the Celtic style in several of the games. For example, Final Fantasy IV's overworld theme has become so popular that several remixes have been made, including one by famous Irish singer Enya. Final Fantasy Crystal Chronicles composer Kumi Tanioka also uses examples of Irish music in several of the tracks, including Departure, Overlooking the Great Ocean, and Promised Grace. Another famous long-running adventure series, The Legend of Zelda, has Celtic-inspired music in some of the games. The Legend of Zelda: The Wind Waker begins with a lively Irish jig featuring two standard Irish instruments, the harp and the fiddle. Fiddle, which is another word for the violin, is featured in the part of the game where the character of Makar, the one that looks like a leaf, learns a lively tune played to him by another character named Fado. It's interesting that the word Fado means destiny, which is a major theme in the Zelda games. The harp is featured in The Legend of Zelda: Skyward Sword, where the character of Link must learn different songs to progress through the game. The main song, called Ballad of the Goddess, is first sung by the character of Zelda. Irish harpist Branna Loughrelin recorded a live version of Ballad of the Goddess with a traditional Irish harp known as a clarsha. Speaking of traditional Irish instruments, you can hear quite a few in the music of video games. Two instruments that are played in the opening of the game Chrono Cross are the bodhrán, or Irish hand drum, and the Irish flute. Other instruments that have their roots in the Irish musical tradition include the banjo, accordion, and the tin whistle. Other fantasy role-playing games with Irish-inspired music include The Elder Scrolls V: Skyrim in tracks such as A Winter's Tale, and Ancient Stones. The massive multiplayer online game World of Warcraft: Warlords of Draenor also contains Irish-style music, which makes sense because its music was written by Irish composer Emer Noon. Noon was also the first female musician to conduct at the Academy Awards in 2020. You can find out more information about her and her music at www.conductrix.com. One of the most famous Irish ballads is a song written in 1913 called Danny Boy. Danny Boy is based off of an older tune called Londonderry Air, which originally came from Northern Ireland in an area called County Derry. The song can be heard in the 2007 game Bioshock, where it is playing in the background when the player visits the apartment of Frank Fontaine, an Irish gangster who serves as the game's main villain.
Must go, and I must bide. But
the song has been adapted many times. If you've ever played in band, you might have played Percy Grainger's Irish tune from County Derry, or you might have heard it sung by famous singers such as Elvis Presley, John Lennon, and the Irish vocal group Celtic Woman.
Celtic music can be enjoyed by people all over the world, whether they are Irish or not. I myself don't have a bit of Irish in me, but my wife's family does, and so does this little guy here. Funny enough, we named him Daniel, but that's honestly just a coincidence. Oh, Danny boy, the pipes are calling.